stars. We polled a studio audience, Christy, not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. It's only blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And for matching the third, $100. Three of our six stars will offer some assistance.
Charles.
It's only a paper moon.
Brett.
It's only make-believe.
Betty.
It's only money.
Three they gave you. You have the option of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
Let's try. It's only money. I'll go with the audience.
All right. She's letting the audience influence her. We'll see how good you are at this. We'll go down there at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. It's only a paper moon. There's the answer that Charlie gave.
That wasn't a request, Brett.
Let's see. Okay, let's look at the next one and see the $250 number. It's only make-believe. When you got two out of the three they've given you so far, I think it's a good omen for you, Christy. Good luck as we slide the big one. Is you're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $5,000. But you get a lucky spin of the star wheel here, you'll double that and play for $10,000. Good luck. Let's all root for a double. Here we go. Answer. If you give us the answer that he has on the card, you get $5,000 in your...
In your... Life. I can't think of anything.
In your life. In your life. Okay, she said in your life will match you for the $5,000. Nick, what do you say there?
I say $950 is good money for her.
That's right.
Yes. In your hat.
In your hat. You've heard that expression. You never heard that expression?
Never.
You would have liked my other one, then.
Yes. In your hat. Yeah, all right, Chrissy, you're not going to meet your new player. Here comes Vic Zlato. Nice to have you back. In case his face looks familiar to you, he was on once before. And there was a little something goofy that went on and make everything was okay. But just to make be perfectly fair to Vic, we said, why don't you come back and have another shot at it? Here he is. And I want to thank you. Good. Run a comment, in case they ever got to where you're from and all that sort of stuff.
You probably did forget. I'm from a little town in Michigan, Cross Village. And it's quite small because in the last election, the supervisor won by one vote, 33-32.
Uh-huh. Boy, that is a small...
And everybody turned out.
Oh, 100%. That's good. They take their voting franchise so seriously. All right, good luck to both players. Here we go. Vic, you can have A or B.
I tossed a coin back there, so I'll have to take A.
Well, you take anyone you want.
I came up heads for A, so I'm going to take A.
Really? All right. Anything you say. Hey, did you hear about the world's thinnest book?
No.
I'll tell you about the world's thinnest book. It's called Blank's Best Jokes.
What is it?
Blank's Best Jokes is the title of the book.
Look at that.
Look at that.
That's Alan Lund.
That's not Alan Lund.
Alan hasn't breathed fire in months.
That thing is really breathing fire. Little sparks coming out of its mouth. That's Darling. Okay, Vic. Here we go. Did you hear about the world's thinnest book? I'll tell you. It's called Blank's Best Jokes.
Richard Nixon's.
Yeah. Richard Nixon's best joke. implication is he's singularly lacking in humor. What do you say to that, Foster?
I don't talk about that.
Oh, you don't talk about that? Well, what are you talking about?
Promise me you won't let somebody know I put this name down if I show it to you.
Okay. I must explain something to you. We find Charles is a most amusing fellow.
Ha! On this program, you ever see him in Vegas?
Oh, all right. Okay, I got it. All right. Can we get out?
Howard Postel.
Howard Postel.
I don't know why I said this. It just seems right. Kate Smith.
Kate Smith. Kate Smith. Best jokes. Oh, you have some interesting answers so far here, Vic. World's thinnest book. It's called Blank's Best Jokes, and he said Richard Nixon. What do you say?
Do you promise you won't let someone see?
Oh, yeah, it'll be our little secret here. Just a...
Brett's best.
Brett's best joke.
Someone with less sense of humor, Gregory Peck.
Gregory Peck. What do you mean by that?
Yeah. Somebody did the other day, Gregory Peck sneezing. Ah, shoo.
Okay, Miss Betty.
You know, I'm just being a good hostess and making a clean breath of it.
Brett, a lot of Bretts in there. So there we are, middle round one. Christy, we've got a question for you, but right now we have a